السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. ربي أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين، وأعوذ بك ربي أن يحضرون. أعوذ بالله السميع، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم، ذلك الدين القيم، فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم، وقاتل المشركين كافة كما يقاتلونكم كافة، واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين. Here we shall discuss today verse number 36 of Surah At-Tawbah. Surah At-Tawbah. What is the speciality of Surah At-Tawbah? Is there any speciality for Surah At-Tawbah regarding Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? Is there any speciality? Whether there is Bismillah or not? In Surah At-Tawbah, whether Bismillah or Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is there in the beginning? Yes or no?
Yes.
No. Yes. No, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is not there. A surah which starts without Bismillah, without Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is Surah At-Tawbah. And in Surah An-Naml, we see there are
two times
Bismillah. Two times it is repeated. Okay. No. You see, today, this month, as per Hijra calendar, this month is
Muharram.
And as per Islamic calendar is called
Hijra calendar.
It is based on Hijra. Hijra is when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was at the age of 53. He got Nubuwat or prophethood in the cave of Hira at the time of at the age of 40. You know, 40. Then after 13 years or 13th year, he, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the command and order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he migrated from Makkah to Medina. He with his followers. Okay. So that is called Hijra. So in commemoration of the Hijra, the Islamic calendar starts. Actually, the Hijra was during the month of Rabiul Awwal. But that year, starting month is calculated as Muharram. After the rituals of Hajj, after the manasik, after the manasiks of Hajj, Muharram. So, it was during the Caliphate. It is when Prophet, when Umar Allah, who was the Khalifa. It is the second Khalifa, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu. Then, so during earlier years, earlier times, Muslims used different types of calendar in different localities. So, during the time of Abu Bakr Allahu Anhu and Umar Allahu Anhu, Islam spread all over the world or through Persia and neighboring countries of Jazirat al-Arab. You know, then at that time, Muslims in different parts of the world or in different countries used different calendars. So there was a need for a unified calendar. Regigrita calendar. A unified calendar. The need for a unified calendar. And there were discussions among the Sahaba. Among the Sahaba. So Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar bin al-Khattab was the Khalifa. Was the Amir. He was the ruler then. So he conducted discussions among the Sahaba. And so many suggestions were there. Some advocated or some people was that it should be the prophet's prophethood date. That is Nubuwat. When Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam got Nubuwat. And some argued, some advocated that is it should be the birth of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That should be the starting starting year. Then, the they arrived at a view that Ali radiallahu anhu suggestions. Ali radiallahu anhu suggested what hijra should be the criteria, or it should be based, it should be made the base of the Islamic calendar. And accordingly, Umar radiallahu anhu accepted that view, and hijra calendar was approved as the Islamic calendar. And even before that, the names of the months were there. Okay. Different names were used and different timings. Okay. Then. Some of the names were similar to this. The names of months almost similar. A little bit difference were there among different localities. Okay. Then. So, you see, the sana, that is the year, consists of, it comprises of how many months?
All of them.
12 months. There are 12 months. So, it is as recorded by, or as ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. Inna iddata shuhuri inda Allah. Quran says, or Allah says in the Holy Quran, verse number 36 of Surah At-Tawbah. Yes, Surah At-Tawbah. Inna iddata shuhuri. Certainly, the days, the number of months. Shahr means?
Month.
Shuhur?
Months.
Okay. The number of months. Indallah. That is with Allah. Is? Ithna ashara. Ashar means? Ashar.
Ten.
Ithna ashar?
12.
Ishroon?
20.
So, ithna ashara shahra. There are 12 months in a calendar year. Fi kitabillah, as it is recorded in the document of Allah, in the record of Allah. Yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal ard. Since the time, the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and earth. That is, from the starting time of this universe itself, or the heavens and the earth. Okay, then. Minha arba'atun hurum. And out of those 12 months, 4 are
prohibited.
Muharram. Hurum. Hurum. Haram. Plural form is hurum. Hurum. Haram. Plural form is hurum. Haram means prohibited. Also, it is, its meaning is sacred. Two meanings are there. Sacred as well as prohibited. So, sacred. Those months are sacred. Also, prohibited months. Why? Prohibited? During those months, what is prohibited?
Fighting
is prohibited. So, fighting is prohibited in other months too. Simply, fighting or killing, in a sense, is prohibited in all months. You know. But, killing in retaliation, that is, killing non-Muslims in retaliation to an act done by the non-Muslims earlier times, to the non-Muslims. Then Muslims can counter-attack them. Okay. But that is prohibited during the months of Ashhurul Hurum. During the months of during the prohibited months. Okay. Only if the non-Muslims attack the Muslims, or the non-Muslims start attacking Muslims during the months, during the prohibited months, then only Muslims are permitted to attack them. Okay, in retaliation. Otherwise, if non-Muslims had attacked earlier, and for that counter-attack is not permitted during the prohibited months. Got the point? Okay. Then, minha arba'atun hurum, ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. And it is the straight deen, straight religion, straight deen. That is, the count of the number of months. Also, the prohibition regarding the 4 months. All are recorded by Allah. And we should, or Muslims should, obey the rules regarding all this. Okay. Then, ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. فَلَا تَظُلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Hence, you should not wrong yourselves You should not wrong yourselves. You should not perform. You should not do any dhulm. Okay. Any wrongs. وَقَاتِلُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ كَافَّةً كَمَا يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ كَافَّةً. And you should قَاتِلُ. You should
fight
المشركين. The مشركين. The idolaters. How? كَافَّةً. Collectively. كَمَا يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ كَافَّةً. As they are collectively fighting against you. So if they come to attack you collectively, then you should also attack them collectively. Otherwise, the Muslim nation will be disintegrated or the Muslim ummah will be ruined. Okay, Islam will be ruined. That's why there it is given permission. If the non-Muslims or if the mushrikeen comes to attack during the prohibited months or they start the attack, then Muslims should counter-attack them. Only that much. Okay. Then. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. وَعْلَمُوا. And you should know. You should know. يَغْلَمْ. عَلِمَ يَغْلَمْ. عَلِمْ. أَنَّ اللَّهَ certainly Allah is مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ with
those
متقين. Yes.
Those who are
pious. Yes. Those who are pious. Taqwa piety, pious, adjective for. Okay, muttaqeen. Those who are taqwa. Those who have taqwa. Okay. Now the tafsir. You see. Tafsir Ibn Kathir. You see. قال الإمام أحمد أن أبي بكر أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خطب في حجته فقال ألا إن الزمان قد استدار كحيته يوم خلق السماوات والأرض. السلف إحدى إثنى عشر شجرة منها أربعة هرم ثلاثة متواليات ذو القعدة وذو الحجة والمحرم ورجب مضر الذي بين جمادى وشعبان ثم قال أي يوم هذا قلنا الله ورسوله أعلم فسكت حتى ظننا أنه سيسميه بغير اسمه قال أليس يوم النهر قلنا بلى ثم قال أي شهر هذا قلنا الله ورسوله أعلم فسكت حتى ظننا أنه سيسميه بغير اسمه قال أليس ذا الحجة؟ قلنا بلى. ثم قال أي بلد هذا؟ قلنا الله ورسوله أعلم. فسكت حتى ظننا أنه سيسميه بغير اسمه. قال أليست البلدة؟ قلنا بلى. قال فإن دماءكم وأموالكم وأحسبه قال فإن دماءكم فإن أغراضكم عليكم حرام كحرمة يومكم هذا في شهركم هذا في بلدكم هذا. وستلقون ربكم فيسألكم عن أعمالكم ألا لا ترجعوا بعدي ضلالا يضرب بعضكم رقاب بعض ألا هل بلعت ألا ليبلع الشاهد منكم الغائب فلعل من يبلغه يكون أو عاله من بعض من سيع. Don't mind. Simple. Okay. Company. Then Imam Ahmad reports, Rahmatullah Ali, reports one hadith and narrated by Abu Bakr. Okay. Anna Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khataba fi hajjatihi. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a speech during his hajj. How many hajj did Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam perform?
Only one
hajj. And that's called
Hajjatul
Wida'. It is farewell hajj. Ahsanti. Then, very good. Then that Hajj, during that Hajj, he made a speech. And it is called a?
Khutbatul
Wida', farewell speech. And in that farewell speech, his speech contained many important subjects. And here, a few is mentioned. Okay. A few words are mentioned here, not the whole speech here. ألا إن الزمان قد استدار كحيئته يوم خلق السماوات والأرض. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, okay, during the Hajj, during his خطبة الوداع, or during the Hajj, okay, then he said, from the time the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and earth, the zaman, the periods are running, and then السنة إثنى عشر شهرا. The year is
12 months.
12 months consists of 12 months. Minha arba'atun hurum. And out of those 12 months, four are
prohibited.
And which are they?
Dhul-Qa'dah, Dhul-Hijjah, Muharram and Rajab.
Yes. So, salasatu mutawaliyat. Dhul-Qa'dah, Dhul-Hijjah, wa Muharram. 3 months are coming in succession. That is, one after that, one, the next one, like that. That is, Dhul-Qa'dah, the next month, Dhul-Hijjah, the next month, Muharram. Okay. Then, Warajab. Warajab, Mular. Alladhi bayna Jumada wa Shaban. Rajab, which is in between Jumada, that is Jumadul Akhir and Shaban. Okay, the previous one, Jumada, Al Akhir, and then the next one, Shaban. And in between, Rajab. And that is called Rajab Mudar by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Why? There is another Rajab. There was another Rajab for the tribe of Rabi'ah. Okay, you have seen? There were different calendars and different systems. Okay. For Rabi'ah tribe, they such Rajab is in between Sha'ban and Shawwal. Sha'ban, that is Mudar. That is Rabi'ah's Rajab is, Rajab was between Shawwal and Sha'ban. Sha'ban and Shawwal. Shaban, the previous one. Shawwal, the next one. Sufficient one. Then, okay. So, that is called the Rajab of Rabi'ah. So, there two Rajab was there. Okay. According to the tribe of Mudar, Rajab was a different age. Different month. Okay. According to the Rabi'ah, Rajab was another month. Okay. So, that's why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam specified here. The Rajab of Mudar. Rajab Mudar. Baina Jumada wa Sha'ban. That is in between Jumadul Akhir and Sha'ban. Okay. And now, we see in the present calendar, Ramadan is in between
Shawwal and
Sha'ban. Sha'ban first, then Ramadan, then
Shawwal.
Like that. Okay. ثُمَّ قَال. Then he said. So, there are 12 months in a year and out of which 4 are prohibited. They are ذُلْقَادَةَ, ذُلْحِجَّةَ, مُحَرَّمْ and رَجَبْ. Okay. Then the Prophet continued his speech. أَيَّ يَوْمٍ هَذَا. He asked the companions, the Sahaba, أَيَّ يَوْمٍ هَذَا. Which day is this? Qulna, then we said, that is the companion said, Abu Bakr, one Sahabi is reporting this hadith. Okay, Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, knows better than us. Okay, Fasakata, then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam kept silent for a while. Then, Hatta lananna annahu sayusammihi bighayr ismih. And we thought, that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam may mention any other name other than this name, the name of the day. Okay. Actually, they knew what day was it. But they kept silent. They thought that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam may mention some other name. That's why they said they kept silent. Or they didn't reply. They said simply only this much. Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and His Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, no, better. Okay, then, قال, then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, أَلَيْسَ يَوْمَ النَّهَر. Is this the day of Nahar, sacrifice? That is, the day of sacrifice, the day of Eidul
Adha.
That is the 10th of Dhul-Hijjah. Okay, then, is this the 10th of Dhul-Hijjah or Yawmun Nahar, the day of sacrifice, the day of the Eid of Eid al-Adha. Okay, then. Qulna, bala. Then they agreed. Okay, bala. Yes. Now. He said, yes. Thumma qala, then he asked it. And the next question. Ayya shahrin hada. Which month is this? Then. Qulna, Allahu rasuluhu a'lam. We said, Allah and His Rasul know better. Fasakata. Then he kept silent for a while. Hatta lanna annahu sayusammihi bighayr ismih. Till we thought that he may say
another name
for that month. Then قال أليس ذو الحجة is it ذو الحجة so ذو الحجة ذو الحجة both pronunciation is there okay قلنا بلا then he agreed then they agreed companions agreed okay yes ثم قال then he said أي بلد هذا which country is this which town is this which city is this قلنا الله ورسوله أعلم الله ورسوله أعلم فسكت he then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم kept silent for a while حتى ظننا أنه سيسميه بغير اسمه till we thought that
another name
he would say another name okay then قال Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أليس ذي البلدة is it the city of مكة our sacred city of مكة قلنا بلى yes it is قال then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم continued فإن دماءكم وأموالكم وأحسبه قلب أغراضكم عليكم حرام كحرمة يومكم هذا في بلدكم هذا في شهركم هذا في بلدكم هذا then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said فإن دماءكم certainly your blood وأموالكم your property وأحسبه قلب أغراضكم and I think he said this much also وأغراضكم and your أغراض your status your status what
sanctity
yes sanctity أغراض no sanctity sanctity حرمت you have doubts Your honor. What? Aural. Auralakum. Your honor. Okay. Your honor. Your status. Your honor. Okay. Auralakum. Alaykum haram. So, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, certainly your blood, your property, and your honor are sacred. All these things. These three things are sacred. How? Fi shahirikum hada, fi baladikum hada. كَهُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا Just like the sanctity of the day of this day of yours. That is, they knew the sanctity of that day even before the advent of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Arabs knew the sanctity, the hurmat of that day. يَوْمُ النَّحْرِ Okay, then كَهُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا فِي يَوْمِكُمْ فِي شَهْرِكُمْ هَذَا In this month of yours. That is, in this month of yours, the Shahr Dhul Hijjah or Dhul Hijjah. Okay? So that Shahr was prohibited or that Shahr, that month was sacred to them even before the advent of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's why he say like that. Okay? Just like the sanctity of this day of yours and this month of yours and this
city
or country of yours. Okay, so the sanctity of Makkah was approved or it was agreed upon in between them, among them. Okay, sanctity of Makkah, no difference of opinion. Okay, so even before the advent of the final Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the sanctity of Makkah, it was there, okay, in their minds. And they considered it too much. Okay, then. So just like the sanctity of this country, just like the sanctity of this month, just like the sanctity of this day, your blood, it is men's blood, human's blood. So no killing is allowed. Then,
property.
Men's property. We should not exploit others. Okay. Then honor. We should not abuse, squald, backbite others. Okay. Then. وَسَتَلْقَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ فَيَسْأَلَكُمْ أَنْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ Then, later, you shall meet your Lord. Later, you shall meet your Lord. You meet your Rabb. That is, meet your Allah. Meet Allah. You shall meet Allah after your
death.
Yes, after your death. وَسَتَلْقَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ لِقَاءُ اللَّهِ لِقَاءُ the liqa of Allah. Okay, then Mr. Taqunun. Fayas alukum an a'malikum. Then he will ask you about your deeds. About your deeds. He will ask, you will be interrogated, you will be questioned, you will be asked. So, only you should do only good deeds here. Okay? Only good deeds. You should not kill others, should not harm others, should not backbite others. Okay? Like that. Then. Allah, you know, Prophet is continuing his speech. لا ترجعوا بعضي الضلالة يضرب بعضكم بعضا. What he said? لَا تَرْجِعُوا بَعْضِي الظُّلَّالَ After me. That means, after Prophet's death, you should not return to, yes, Mushrikeen, or return to Dhalala. Here, Dhalala. Dhalalat. You should not return to Dhalalat. So you were in Dhalalat. We know, before the arrival of Islam, Aus and Khazraj, the two prominent tribes of Medina, they were fighting each other for simple reasons. They were fighting for long years. Okay, for prolonged years, for simple reasons. Okay, then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam made their united under one head. Okay, under one liwa. Under one flag of Islam. Okay. Then they were made brothers, sisters. Okay. They were made brothers and sisters. They shared. They shared their properties. They helped each other. Like that. Aus and Khazraj. And like that, other tribes too. So, you should not return to such a situation after my death. Prophet is giving this speech in the Hajj, Hajjatul Wida. And after that Hajj, after that speech, he did live only for a few months. The next Hajj season, he was not there. He died. So, it was a very famous speech. Okay. So, لا ترجعوا بعضي الضلالة. You should not return to ضلالت. You should not go astray after me, after my death. يضرب بعضكم بعضا. He is killing one another, cutting the heads, chopping the heads of one another. You should not like that. You see, here, now also, it's continuing. Yemen, Syria, in many other parts, Muslims, internal fighting. Okay, Muslims fighting each other. For some or other reasons, they are fighting each other. It is prohibited, totally prohibited. Okay. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam warned us not to fight each other, not to fight others too. Innocent non-Muslims should also not be killed. Innocent non-Muslims should not be killed. They shall be killed only when they came to attack to a Muslim nation. That too upon the commandment of this army like that. There should be Muslim rule then only. In secular country, individuals should not take arms against non-Muslims. Even if they attack, they can rely upon democratic means. Okay, that is the real path. Okay, then individuals are not allowed to take laws, rules in their hands or take arms against the individual, other individuals. Okay, we have police. Or army, we have quads, everything is there. Okay, then. Ala hal ballaghtu? No. Have I given you the message? The baligh, balagha means to reach. So, have I given you the message? Have I given you the message? I am sent to you as a messenger. I have given you the message. You should testify that. Have I given the message? Allah. You should know. لِيُبَلِّغْ أَشَّاهِدُ مِنْكُمْ الْغَائِبُ You should. Those who are present here must reach this message. Must hand over this message to those who are absent here. Okay, then hearing this speech, after the speech, after the Hajj, they went to different parts of the world. And here in Kerala, in India, also they came. Malik ibn Dinar, one Sahabi, and 12, Malik ibn Dinar, 12 others. Okay, he came here and propagated Islam. That's why we got a luck to be Muslims. Okay, okay. But we should will be Muslims only if we act according to Quran and Sunnah. Okay, simply by born in a Muslim family, born to a Muslim mother and father, will not entitle us to be a Muslim, real Muslim. Okay, so we should work hard according to Quran and Sunnah. We should give this message to others also. Okay, follow, follow. Then also we should pray for Allah. Allahumma ahsin awaqibana. Allahumma ahyina lil Islam. Allahumma amitna ma'al imani wat tuba. Like that. Okay, then. Ameen. So, ليبلغ الشاهد منكم الغيب فلعل من يبلغه يكون أو عاله من بعض من سمع. Then those who directly hear from me, they are giving knowledge or transferring it to others, and those who hear from you may sometimes will be better than or will comprehend better than those who hear directly from me. Okay, so you should transfer this knowledge to others. You should propagate this knowledge. You should transfer this knowledge to others. Sometimes they may be comprehending better than yours. Okay, better than some of you. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.